Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Timeline or chronology of modern Western art. Now there is a slight problem in studying the timeline or chronology of modern Western art. The problems are manifold. For example, the most serious problem is where do you begin the history of modern Western art? For many scholars, modern Western art begins to unfold itself from mid-19th century, most specifically from the period when the movements like Romanticism or Realism came into being. For some scholars, no. Today, from the perspective of today's visual culture, when you look at Romantic movement or the movement of Realism of mid-19th century, they don't look modern enough. They don't look traditional. Now, according to the second group of scholars, the story of modern art begins from, or ideally it should begin from, early 20th century. And more specifically from 1907, when Picasso painted his first cubist painting. So cubism seems to be often the beginning of modern Western art. So far, so good. But then there is a third group of art historians who would love to identify neither realism and romanticism nor cubism, but something in between, famously known as Impressionism and Post-Impressionism as the beginning of modern art. So what do you do? Now, looking at the various positions proposed by different scholars and art historians over a long period of time, it appears that Western art, and particularly modern Western art, has not one, but many beginnings. There are many beginnings, really speaking, many moments from which you can start your story of modern Western art. It has to be your story, how you look at modern Western art, where you would like to start your story of modern Western art. There is nothing so historically correct in the sense your idea of modernism may differ from my idea of modernism. Therefore, the story of beginning is going to be different from each other. Nevertheless, mid-19th century seems to be a fairly good idea to start looking at the history of modern Western art. Whether the modernity itself began from that point or not, as far as art is concerned, that is a complex theoretical issue. But the story certainly begins from mid-19th century, because already 50 to 100 years before that, modernism in the political, in the social history had already begun. So, therefore, modernism, before we come to modern art, let us look at the idea of modernism very briefly. That's going to help us to identify the story of modern art within the historical panorama. Modernism in general began in the 18th century with industrialization and the French Revolution in 1789. and brought fundamental change to all areas of society, causing a break with old traditions. So break with old traditions seems to be a running theme, a consistent feature, whether you're talking about modernism in general or modern art in particular. And the accompanying painting that you see along with this slide is a wonderful depiction of French Revolution, painted by Delacroix. So these events, like this very important historical events like French Revolution and industrialization, were so important that artists, or the focus of the artists, rapidly shifted from the earlier traditional themes to this new contemporary themes, the topical themes, the topical subject matters, like French Revolution here, or Industrial Revolution in this painting. So, in a way, it is a deliberate attempt on part of the artists to begin the story of modern art. But at the same time, we must not forget that the social, political, economic situation itself was changing so rapidly and so deeply and so effectively that artists who were receptive to their time, who were sensitive to their own time, were compelled or felt the urge, a very sincere urge, to paint the images of this time depicting these events. So modernism in general and modern art in particular were pretty related to each other right from the beginning. So you can also have a painting like this where the subject matter is all about medical study. A group of medical people, doctors, they are studying a body, a corpse, as part of the medical study, and that becomes the subject matter of painting. So, modernism established itself as an explicit model of thought and ideas in the 19th century, and from that time on, modern thinkers, scientists, artists, musicians, authors, philosophers, all kinds of people began to perform a new task. They began to follow a new trajectory, a new path. They became the pathfinders, and they were making some progress in the society. They were looking at, they were looking forward to make some progress, not to hold on to something that is traditional. So, a shift is visible from the age of conservatism to an age of progress, to an age of liberal ideas, liberal thoughts. So, these modern thinkers, they felt the urge to liberate society from the shackles of the past. The modernists, in every field, were often misunderstood. This is also true. An artist, of course, visual artists were often misunderstood by their own contemporaries because modern artists, they looked, and their art also looked outrageous, crazy, and they were not comprehensible, difficult to understand. They were not in tandem with what a society expects them to be. But they didn't care. They went ahead with their works with undaunted spirit and enthusiasm. So a certain spirit, an element of spirit, could be identified as a major driving force for this modern artist, modern art, and modernism in general. So modern art naturally followed this pattern of progress, encouraging artists and groups of artists not to align with common ideals or fashionable trends, but to constantly seek out new and often uncomfortable territory, questioning and expanding the boundaries of artistic mediums, concepts, and techniques. So, whereas in traditional art, despite different stylistic features and stylistic differences, generally speaking, the tendency was to hold on to something that was considered classical or traditional. But in modern art, the artist seemed to be continuously trying to push the limits, the boundaries of artistic mediums, artistic expressions, concepts, techniques, and thereby continuously redefining art, questioning art. So, a series of innovations, a series of discoveries were taking place as you go along the timeline or as you follow the chronology of modern art. In other words, with every phase in modern art, with every art movement and individual artist, modern art was once again questioned and redefined. Now, none of these art movements were homogeneous, whether we are talking about Cubism or Impressionism, Post-Impressionism, Futurism, Surrealism, Abstract Expressionism, whatever, pop art, op art. As you go along and follow the journey of modern Western art throughout this course, gradually it becomes very clear that none of these art movements were homogeneous. Each had its own time, its own moment of emergence. Each had its own place, its own location to operate. And each had its own concerns. And they all emerged from specific situation with strong artistic character and personal style. Now, this is also what makes modern art very interesting. That despite sharing certain common ideas, certain common features, modern art is extremely diverse in its forms, in its ideas, in its techniques, in its mediums, in its philosophies, in its ideologies. A constant drive for innovation, exploration, and experimentation in modern art made the story of modern art extremely heterogeneous, with constant shifts in ideology and style. Because innovation was the keyword. Invention was the main drive. Experimentation was the call of the game. And most of the modern artists followed these ideas. So our timeline of modern art is thus never fully comprehensive or satisfying, you know. But it can provide a basic idea about the sequence of events, and that is exactly why we are looking at the timeline. But a timeline or a chronological study can never give you the complete story, can never tell you the complete story. It can only give you a basic guideline of the way the sequence of events unfolded themselves. Now, the key moments of beginning. The beginning, as I was telling you, the story of modern art seems to be having a lot of beginnings, many beginnings. And the key moments of these beginnings are Romanticism that continued, that took place between late 18th to mid-19th century, Realism, which was a mid-19th century phenomenon, Impressionism, late 19th century phenomenon, Post-Impressionism, late 19th century and early 20th century phenomenon, Fauvism, early 20th century, Cubism, early 20th century. So more or less, from mid-19th century to early 20th century, we already see a number of important moments or movements or artistic innovations. And all these innovations, all these moments, will have a claim, certainly, to be considered or to be identified as the beginning of the story of modern art. But instead of going for any selection of preferences, it would be rather useful for us to look at all the possible beginnings. And this is what we will be doing from our next, that is the fourth module. Now, apart from different beginnings or moments, chronologically speaking, modern art, location-wise, also differ a lot amongst themselves. For example, if from Romanticism to Cubism, all these movements, from late 18th to mid 19th to early 20th century, after Cubism, have happened in France, then later we will come across many art movements which did not take place in France. So different movements and moments of modern art not only happened in different times, but they also happened in different places. So these movements we mentioned right now, Romanticism, Realism, Impressionism, Post-Impressionism, Fauvism, Cubism, if these movements took place in France, then we also have other movements like German Expressionism, which took place in Germany, as the name suggests. We have a very specific but a short-lived movement, but a very important art movement in early 20th century called Futurism that happened in Italy. We have another very important art movement which left a great impact on design, that is called Digital or the Style movement, and that happened in Holland. So not that everything happened in France or everything happened in one place. The story of modern art is not only spread over time, it is also spread over different spaces. So from Romanticism till Cubism, France, and specifically Paris, seem to be the center of modern art. Then comes German Expressionism, which, as I told you, as the name suggests, that took place in Germany, in places like Berlin, in Munich, in Dresden. Then we have Futurism, again in early 20th century, and Futurism flourished in neither France nor Germany, but in Italy. So what a shift of place from France to Germany to Italy. Then we have abstract art, 1907 onwards, and though it started in Paris by Cubist painters, artists like Picasso and Braque, but it was spreading in other countries as well, like Italy and later in Germany, and much later also outside Europe in America. Then again, come to another early 20th century very important movement called Dada movement, and this took place neither in France, nor in Italy, nor in Germany, nor in England, but in Zurich. Completely a different place. And the movement that followed Dada, which is partly an extension of Dada, but also by its own merit, a completely different movement called Surrealism, that again, at least the emergence, the story of Surrealism begins in France. We have these famous painters. Dali, a Spanish painter called Dali, the Rene Magritte, and others. It started in France. But then, of course, it started spreading elsewhere as well. Then we have this style art movement, which happened in Dutch, Holland. So, entire Europe seems to be participating in the formation of modern art, not just France. Yes, France and previously Italy. These two were the main centers of art movements in Europe for a long time, But we shouldn't forget the way the other countries, other nations, people from other places, they're also participating in the story of modern art. Then, in the later part of the century, from 1940s onwards, in 1940s, 50s, and 60s, three very important art movements, like abstract expressionism, pop art, and pop art. These three art movements not only shared a common time frame, mostly from 1940s, 50s, and 60s, but they also shared a common space, that is, the United States of America. In fact, the post-war developments in modern Western art, the most important developments that happened in the post-war, that is, post-Second World War, in the 40s or the mid or late 40s, it's America, it's USA. USA becomes the main center for the post-war developments in modern art. Then Europe, because Europe was completely devastated in the Second World War, it took time to resurrect, to come back, and once it was able to come back, it followed suit. So it seemed that at the end of the Second World War, in the 1940s, the story of modern Western art was hijacked by the Americans. And America produced some of the greatest artists of late modern art from that period onwards. This is what makes the chronology of modern art very interesting. Even if we have managed to somehow negotiate with the beginnings of modern art, we yet do not know where to end the story of modern art. Usually we say, okay, around 1960s and 70s, particularly at the end of these movements called abstract expressionism, pop art and pop art, modern art, the mainstream story of modern Western art comes to end, and this is the moment when postmodernism picks up from around 1970s. Once again, another group of scholars would not be ready to subscribe to this view. They would rather say no. Even if postmodern seems to be making its presence felt from 1970 onwards, it never means the end of modernism. Modernism continues, and simultaneously, postmodernism picks up its speed and culminates into contemporary art. It is art right now, the time that we are living in. If you go back to the chronology term order once again, I'm sure you will also notice another very interesting thing. That though we are through this chronology, through this timeline, we are trying to put the moments of modern art or the events of modern art in a sequence, which is one after the other. But when you look at the date, when you look at the year, you will certainly notice that the dates overlap, the periods overlap, the time brackets overlap. So overlapping of different phases of modern art seems to be a part and parcel of the story. So simultaneous things, simultaneous movements, simultaneous art ideas looming in different places at the same time, this is also reality of modern Western art. And it is in that sense, the timeline of modern Western art, the chronology of modern Western art is a little complex. That if you are expecting to see a linear story, one thing happening after the other, you will be very, very disappointed. No. Cubism really did not wait for Fauvism to come to an end. When Cubism started, the movement of ideas began to generate itself from 1907 onwards, futurism was also very active. So, movements and art ideas could flourish simultaneously, not only in different countries, but even in the same country, in the same place. And that is the beauty, that is the fun of reading or studying modern art, this simultaneity. The different smaller stories, different segments of the same story happening simultaneously in different places, more or less at the same time. So to summarize today's module, we have observed a few important aspects, few important issues which will have a bearing on our future study of modern Western art when we are looking at the chronology. That is number one. Modern art has not one but several beginnings. Similarly, it is very difficult to ascertain a moment or a date or a year to identify the end of modernism. The modern art has perhaps not come to an end, according to some view. According to another point of view, modern art is over, postmodern art has taken over. We are not going to resolve this question right away, but we are looking at the scenario, the different arguments. Secondly, modern art developed in different places, in different countries at the same time. Thirdly, the simultaneity of modern art. Different movements, different important artists being active, working almost at the same time, and may not be in different countries, could be in the same place itself. So, we see overlaps. The time brackets in modern art are constantly overlapping with each other. Now, with this idea of chronology or timeline, and with this idea of the prehistory of modern art, from the next module, that is the fourth module onwards, now we shall be tracking the story of modern art. And this is what we will be going to start from our fourth module of the first week. Thank you.